Hello friends, myself Dr. Maddineni Srinivas, certified dermatologist. I will teach dermatology related MCQs in my YouTube channel. So if you are not yet subscribed, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel for all these kind of awesome MCQs. So this is the today's MCQ, 38 year old woman presented with the skin lesions as shown in the image. And if you observe the image, you are able to see that there is some erythema which is present over bilateral cheeks, and also you are able to see at the nasal tip there is some erythema. So some more clues are mentioned in the question. So Diascopy, that is application of the pressure with the help of a glass slide over the skin, is called as Diascopy. It is also called as vitropression. This reveals apple jelly nodules. Okay, this is the one clue which is given. And her serum angiotensin converting enzyme levels, that is AS levels, are elevated, higher than the normal. So what is the possible diagnosis? So by looking at this image and by looking at this apple jelly nodules, you should be very careful to not jump into the diagnosis of lupus vulgaris. Okay, why? Because yes, you are right, apple jelly nodules, you might have pie-hearted that yes, it is seen in lupus vulgaris, which is the most common type of cutaneous tuberculosis. But in the MCQ, apart from apple jelly nodules, there is one more clue which is given, that is this patient is also having elevated ACE levels. And with this, you should know that apart from lupus vulgaris, there is one more dermatological disease which is very important, in which also we can see apple jelly nodules on Diascopy. And the another diagnosis is, yes, it is lupus pernio. That is the answer here. Why? Because it is this condition in which both apple jelly nodules and ACE levels can be elevated, ACE levels can be seen. And lupus pernio, it is nothing but it is a very characteristic, a distinctive cutaneous manifestation of sarcoidosis. I hope you all know, basically it is a multi-system granulomatous disorder. You might have read this in your general medicine in detail. In the cutaneous manifestations of sarcoidosis, this lupus pernio is a very important cutaneous manifestation, which you must remember, which is going to present as erythematous papules or nodules or patches, mainly involving the face. And if you observe carefully, the tip of the nose, the involvement of the tip of the nose is also a characteristic feature of this condition, lupus pernio. Also, clinically, lupus vulgaris and lupus pernio can be easily differentiated. Why? Because lupus vulgaris, the lesion is going to have an advancing end at one end of this lesion, and there is going to be an other end of the lesion which is going to undergo regression. That is, the skin over one end of this lesion, you can observe that it will advance and it will involve the normal skin, whereas at the other end there will be a healing of this lesion with atrophic scarring. So unlike that, lupus pernio is not going to have such a picture. So pause this video and try to guess your answer. Point friends, do like this video if you like this kind of short videos.